Hey guys, welcome to another episode of Spotlight with Katie. Today on the show, I have someone you have loved. And of course, you all love Scam 1992. And now, I have Prateek Gandhi on the show today. So hi Prateek, and welcome to the show. Happy New Year, first of all.
Happy New Year.
And congratulations on your recent success.
Oh, thank you. Thank you very much.
So, Prateek, I'm going to ask you some interesting 20 questions. And trust me, none of the questions will show at all. So, these are some interesting questions which I'm trying to figure out you as a person and something you need to know. All said, can I? One by one?
Yes. Shoot.
So what's the first thing that you did in the morning today?
First thing in the morning? I just brushed my teeth there.
Okay. And how would Prateek introduce Prateek of 20 years old? So you have to introduce yourself to your 20 year old.
So my 20-year-old, so I mean current self to my 20-year-old self, correct, is what you're saying. Yeah. Oh, then I would like to say that don't worry, this is where you're going to reach. So just enjoy the journey.
All right. And now since you've received a lot of acclaims and people have recognized your work with a lot of feedback, what's the best piece of advice you think you've got?
Best piece of advice that I've got is just be true to yourself and add value to whatever you do.
Okay. And who is your celebrity crush?
Celebrity crush as such? Oh my god. So, I mean, once upon a time, of course, Sridevi ji, because I've been watching her since my school time. And there are lots of films that I've watched. So, yeah.
Okay, I think I lost the name there. Can you give us
Sridevi.
And that's everybody's favorite. I cannot forget.
Yeah, man.
Baba Hawaii.
Oh my god. She's super cool.
Which film actually you saw that you were like, okay, I am her big fan? It's a difficult
Sadma.
Choice.
Sadma, Mr. India, lots and lots of films, man.
I think I saw Mr. India at least 20 times when I was a kid. And that Hawa Hawa thing is still in my head.
Oh yes, even my daughter loves that film. So we keep watching it again and again.
Oh wow. Okay. We have not been able to travel all this through the COVID. But which is your favorite destination where you would like to go and at least have your own time?
I guess I want to go to Ladakh once more. I had been there, though I was there for my shows, so could not explore a lot of places there.
Mm-hmm.
But yes, Ladakh is the place that I want to go.
Wow. It's on my bucket list for sure. I've been planning it for about 2-3 years. But I'll also plan that. Okay. Do you search yourself on Google a lot?
No. Earlier, I did that to find out some lost articles or something.
All right. So, off late, have you seen a lot of memes on Scam 1992 or on you?
Oh, yes. There are lots and lots of memes.
Any
on me, on the dialogues, on those scenes.
So, which is your personal favorite? Maybe one or two you remember?
Oh, there were lots and lots of memes. Man. I guess Risk Hai Toh Isk Hai has been used widely and variedly with a lot of different thought process behind it.
Mm-hmm.
There was this one meme that one of the condom companies made. Ishq hai to risk hai.
Wow, that's amazing. What a perfect use. So, how did you react to it?
Oh, we laughed like mad, man, the moment I received it. We had our cast group, our Scam cast group on WhatsApp. So we were just discussing this. This is crazy.
This is like the most creative way of doing it. I am in
very, very creative way.
Wow, that's amazing. So when you're shooting so much, when you are constantly traveling, I believe you're shooting again from tomorrow. What is that favorite show that you're glued on to?
You see, I mean, frankly speaking, I hardly can watch anything. Mm-hmm. Because if I'm constantly traveling or something, then most of the time that I have to read a lot of things. So most of the travel time goes behind reading or researching about something. But there are a few shows which are, so my pending list is long, mm-hmm. and things keep on adding into this. So if I just talk about my pending list, then I think I have to, you know, close myself in a room for almost a year to finish all those things.
Wow.
So many pending things. And there are lots of friends, and you know, lots of colleagues. Everybody keeps suggesting something or the other. ये देखना, ये देखना, और ये सब देखना बाकी है मेरा.
So anyone which you think यार जैसे ही मौका मिलेगा ये first tattoo मिलेगा.
अभी मुझे first क्या देखना है? हाँ, The Crown.
Oh, you must watch it. Even I recommend that.
Yeah, I know. Yeah, I have. Lot of recommendations that I have received, so I have to watch that first.
You have to. So yeah, you love listening to music?
Oh yes.
So what's your current favorite that's constantly running on the loop?
I just did one music video for Sachin Jigar, which is Apke Sawan, So that got released, I guess, 20 days back.
Okay.
But that is still running on loop. It's a very, very soothing music. I mean, 90s has been recreated in that music, so yeah, I loved it.
I am a diehard 90s music fan. I think that era was...
Oh my God.
I cannot...
Ah, man.
The Sajans and the... Sada's and everything is something I can't fade out with easily. So that's amazing. So tell me one thing. Are you a night person? Do you work at night? Are you working late?
Not really. If given a chance, I mean, I would want to finish early.
Okay.
And I'm a morning person. Absolutely morning person.
So what happens when you have a midnight craving for some snack? What food do you pounce on?
Okay, if I'm too hungry, then I eat anything that comes my way. I'm a vegetarian. But generally, I prefer homemade food, so I keep searching for some homemade snacks.
Alright. So.
But then, sometimes you have a, you know, solid craving of ice cream. Or kheer.
So you like ice
cream? It's very difficult, though. Yes.
So when you say ice cream, so let me shuffle my question back. Your funniest childhood memory around the ice cream, something that you've done to get some ice cream into your hand.
Oh, so I'm a vegetarian, and in Surat, so once I went to a restaurant with one of our neighbors. Mm-hmm. So they took all the kids from the society.
Okay.
Some occasion, I don't remember. We went there, but that restaurant was a non-vegetarian restaurant. So, I mean, everything was available there. And I said, I just looked at the other table and there was some non-vegetarian food served. So, I didn't even have ice cream there. I said, no, I'm not. Way back in school. I said, no, I'm a vegetarian. They tried too hard to make me understand that ice cream has nothing to do with this. But I was... I said, no, I'm not going to eat.
So finally, did you have an ice cream that day?
No. Then I came out home without eating anything.
Okay. So, which is your personal favorite?
Ice cream?
Yeah.
I like vanilla. I can eat vanilla anytime.
With hot chocolate sauce?
No chocolate. I am not a big chocolate fan. With the chocolate flavor, I don't enjoy that much.
Okay.
So vanilla, and you know, back in the days, I guess it's still we still get it. Raspberry dolly is what we call. Yeah. So its outer layer is raspberry, and inside it's vanilla. So that was my favorite. That's still my favorite.
Okay. So your favorite superhero?
My favorite superhero, He-Man.
Hero. Oh, He-Man.
A hero that used to. He-Man, yeah. He-Man was a cartoon though. I mean, I had never seen a film of it.
The Doordarshan one.
Ah, yeah. Hey, he used to take out that sword and he used to shout, "I got the power." I still remember those days, man. Lovely TV memories.
It was amazing because I remember Sunday morning 8:39 it used to come.
Ramayan se pehle.
Ramayan se pehle aata. And I used to fight watching for that serial. Oh yes.
Oh my god.
And I'm sad it's never come back again. It's a lost series.
Yeah, man.
There at all. And today's
generation. It was a lovely series, lovely cartoon.
It was lovely, and today's generation has not seen it.
No. It's a good time to bring it back.
And I still remember that about Darawa Sher used to get that power and he'd turn into a
philosopher. Yeah.
And that skull guy was amazing. I forgot.
Skull guy, yeah.
And that small girl used to fly in the air whenever he wanted
to. Yes.
Those cartoon days were fantastic. I love those.
Fantastic, man.
Okay, so now the trend is everybody's working out, everybody's health conscious, fit. What's your favorite fitness regime that you like?
My favorite fitness regime is all bodyweight training and mixed martial arts.
Okay.
So, I mean, I can work out anytime, anywhere, without any equipment.
Mm-hmm. All right. Okay. Five things that you cannot leave the house without.
Five things that I cannot leave the house without is, of course, mobile, wallet, cards.
Okay.
These are the basic that you need. Shoes.
All right. And what is the one craziest fan moment that you faced till now?
Craziest fan moment or the craziest moment?
Anything, a fan moment or a general moment, whatever you want to share.
Oh, there are a lot of such moments, yeah. Okay, so earlier when I used to, long back, when I came to Bombay, I was pretty new. And I was always in hurry when I had to reach somewhere. I was always running on the roads, catching bus, trains and all. So once I remember, I used to sit Parla. Went to the ticket window and I was so much in a hurry that I just told that ticket vendor, I said that one parla. Vendor says, bahar aake mujhe dekho, to pagal hai, kyun kya hua, parla mein to khada hai. Bola, haan, charge it. It is a thing with me that I forget a lot of names. So there are a lot of time it happens that I stop the rickshaw to go somewhere and I don't know where am I going. So I sit inside and I normally say, ab chalo main batata.
So
मतलब मुझे सोचना पड़ता है कि कौन सी जगह
So if it happened you've gone somewhere else कहीं और सोच के कहीं और पहुंच गए
नहीं एक बार मैं ट्रेन में सो गया था तो लास्ट स्टेशन पे पहुंच गया and that time I saw Mankhur for the first time कि ये कौन सा स्टेशन है यार
Okay you have been into theater you have done a lot of performing arts When an actor gets into serious acting, what are the three roles that you think inspired you ki, okay, I really want to become an actor. Those three characters or films or roles that you think were the turning point of your life, that you saw?
So I think I picked up theater at a very, very early age. I was just in fourth standard.
Okay.
And back then, we never used to see a lot of theater around happening. Where I am, as an audience, if I watched something. But not too many films also. Because we never had television at home back then. So, tab toh aisa tha. So I guess theater has just become a part of my life so early that I don't even remember when I decided to be an actor. But there were few actors, few characters, few roles that have inspired me or strengthened my faith that, yes, this is what I enjoy doing. I'm on a right track. This is what I love. And there are a lot of such characters, a lot of such roles. So if I, as I told you earlier, Sadma was one of the films that I had seen during my childhood. That inspired me so much that what kind of performance is this? And how can you create characters so real?
Mm. That's nice.
You know, so that is one character. Then I had seen this film, Will Smith's film, Pursuit of Happiness.
Oh, yes.
That is a lovely film.
Run
I was a big Jackie Chan fan then, Bruce Lee and Jackie Chan. That is sheer out of my you know, passion towards martial arts and the way they used to create those fight sequences. So all those things used to intrigue me a lot.
So, as an actor, you have a lot of freedom to accept and adapt various characters, languages. You can go to any length to become whatever character you would like to play. So, what language do you want to experiment as an actor? Okay, this is another language that I want to try my fields on or my hands on.
Oh, I want to do, you know, all regional cinema which is available, go and work. So I am open to learn any different language. As of now, I can speak Hindi, English, Marathi, and Gujarati. A little bit of Bengali is what I've tried on stage also. But yeah, all three South Indian languages. I have always, you know, found it very intriguing to learn and to talk in those languages. So that's what I want to do, for sure.
That's interesting. So basically, you want to cover every possible medium of performing.
Yeah, because I see this is, I mean, after performing in three different languages on stage, I have realized one thing that, you know, each and every language has a different grammar when it comes to writing the language, speaking the language, reading it. It also has a different grammar of performance.
Correct.
That is very interesting to explore as an actor.
Wow. So, like Scam 1992 wasn't an OTT platform, right? OTT has actually broadened the aspect of its audiences, viewerships and stuff like that. What is your take on OTT and the future of OTT?
I think OTT is a boon right now and best time for actors to be around, to be working. Because OTT has changed the entire scenario, the entire game also. And now it is no more formula driven. Nobody is searching for only known faces and only, you know, actors who can pull the crowd, like all those famous stars and faces. Now it is all content driven. So now the content is hero and we are all there to add value to the script and the content.
Correct.
So I guess OTT is giving a lot of opportunities for actors like me who are coming from a different route altogether.
Correct. Okay. So when you say that OTT is giving you a lot of platforms to actors like you, so which is that one role that you played is different from you but is closest to you?
Harshad Mehta. It's absolutely very, very different to me from what I am right now.
Okay.
But it is a very close to my heart, the character.
Really?
Yeah.
Okay. So, is he Vatpen one of your favorite dialogues from this series?
Success ke hai. Failure ke baad ka naya chapter.
Awesome. So, isi baat pe, why don't you tell my audiences that it's a message for all the aspiring actors out there? Because you are definitely a success story and an inspiration to a lot.
So, I think as an individual, nobody wants to fail. And when we talk about this, so there is no blame game allowed in this entire scheme of things. Don't blame others for anything. Whenever things are not working, it is still giving us an opportunity to improve. And that's what I kept thinking all this while, which has helped me. So without being bitter, keep trying, keep working, be there on your skills. Because you don't know when the opportunity will come, but you know how you can prepare yourself for that opportunity which might come anytime. So just stick around and keep working, guys.
Wow, that's really a good one. Thank you so much for being on the show with me. It was really a pleasure talking to you. And I've learned a lot that you have spoken, because youngsters these days always are afraid of failures and people generally don't get that so easily. But it's really nice to see you giving that kind of a strong message.
I feel fail early, fail fast should be the correct formula.
Correct.